What are you doing, Sneakers? Ah! Oh my goodness.
Give me a kiss.
Zara is number 9. Zara is number 9 of my children, and you know, all of my children I have a bond with. I have a really, really strong bond with my my 3-year-old. One day I will speak about her and her story, but the reason I'm thinking about number 9 and the reason why my baby number 9, Zara, is special is because she's a child that was planned, number 1, because I said I wanted another child before I turned 40, and I'm 39. I got pregnant with her when I was 38, and I had her when I was 39, so she's number 9, and she's not the last child. People always ask me, how many children do you want to have? Are you going to have more after you have this one, or the one before that, and the one before that? And my answer is always like, or probably. I don't give anybody the satisfaction to tell me what I'm supposed to do with my body. I knew as a child that I wanted children. I didn't make that known because I was very athletic. I was very into sports and things of that nature, and I didn't come off as the motherly type, if you can do that in high school. I don't know, whatever. I did at the age of 18. I got married, and I had my first 4 children. Their father, I know since I was like 11 or 12, and his older sister and my older sister were best friends. We went to the same church. I'll talk about their father on another video. But anyway, she's number 9, and she's not the last one, but she's special because she was planned, and then, like, you know, she's smart already, you guys. What's today? Today is December 28th, okay? Today is December 28th, and I, yesterday, was talking to her, and I asked her a question. I asked her if she was okay, and I was like, yeah, and she was like, yeah, and I was like, oh my God. And me and my husband, we like looked at each other like, oh my gosh, she's like 4 weeks and 8 days old and she's already responding. The reason why she's doing that is because in the womb, and even more so now, I'm telling my daughter how beautiful she is, right? How smart she is. And I'm telling her this, and I'm feeling it in my core, and I'm telling her because this is exactly what she's going to do, and this is what I've done with my other children. Proof of that, with my 3-year-old, I definitely know that she's very smart. Since she was about 2, you can literally carry a regular conversation with her, and I'll insert now.
Mm-hmm. Lila went to camp. I thought she went to practice.
Oh.
Kari went to the program for the team, like at the team.
Guys. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I want.
You want what?
A beetle. A Dalmatians.
Dalmatian.
No, Dalmatians.
What are these new?
Oh, okay.
Beetle mine.
What else?
Beetle mine.
Why do you keep talking about Yadira? What did Yadira do?
Yadira, talk about.
Talk about what?
Kari had
She was talking about Kari?
Yes.
What did she say?
I said, Yadira has. Naya.
They was talking about Naya too?
Yes. Naya yes.
Oh, Naya was dancing. You said Naya dance?
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
Yadira dancing me. Naya dancing me.
She was dancing with you?
Yes.
Okay.
Naya.
You're talking about me, right, Mom?
No, she said Naya. She didn't say Zanai.
Sabia. Talk about.
Why do you say Sabia? You saying Nabia?
No, talking about.
Who are you talking about? There's nobody named Sabia. There's Nabia, but not Sabia.
Sabia.
Hey, Mommy.
Yes.
Yes. I got a Saturday. Saturday.
Saturday.
And that's the day.
That's the day. That Saturday is the Sabbath.
Sabbath.
Yes, Saturday is the Sabbath.
I'm tired.
You have milk.
No. Apple.
Okay, apples. What else?
I did of awesome.
This is like a presentation.
That's what it seems like. Yes, Mommy. I'm listening. Yes, baby. She took what?
Take the icing.
Hold on.
I'm gonna take the icing.
I'm
gonna take the icing. I'll take the icing now.
Take the icing now?
Take the icing. Ew!
That's Mickey Mouse. She take Dita, what? What did Dita take?
Dita take spoon. Give me a.
The spoon? She said, give me the spoon?
No.
You took it from her?
No.
Okay, then what did you do?
Dapa said, take the phone.
Grandpa said, take the phone? Okay.
Dita, take the phone. Give me a.
She said, give me it.
Take the phone.
And what
Naya, take the phone.
Naya took the phone too? Okay. The longest story ever in history.
Mommy!
I'm listening, baby. Go ahead. What?
So, absolutely. Her teachers even said that they're going to skip her. She's in pre-K right now, but they want to skip her up to... Yeah, baby. They want to skip her up to TK. They want to skip her up because they say she knows all her letters, she knows all her colors, she knows, and she's only three, and she knows more, she can carry a real true conversation with an adult. We're not talking about like a child conversation, we're talking about an adult conversation. And she knows really big words. And the only reason why she's like that because me and her father, we speak very eloquently, if you will. And or because we both, I know my husband, he's very, very smart. I'm as smart as I am, but I don't think I'm smarter than my husband. He just has an impeccable memory. but you know, you pass on certain genes down to your children. But then when you speak those to life, to your children, you speak them outward in the universe to your children, then that has an effect. It's just happening a lot faster now. It's crazy. She's only a month old. So anyway, yes, I do want to have more. And I think people think it's crazy, like why and how and what are you going to do? And I can't even deal with one. That's you. That's you. That's not me. That's you. And I can't help it but to think that people think children are a curse or a hindrance. And they haven't hindered me from doing anything. Insert. So, I'm just thankful. And then at the same time, my body is, I'm able to do it. A lot of people out there aren't able to have babies, and because of, you know, sicknesses and or they're barren and whatever the situation is. Or some people just choose not to have children, which to me is just, I couldn't imagine my life without my children, you know, so. And I'm able to, like, my body, I can carry children. And yes, I've been offered to be a surrogate mother multiple times. And of course, I refused. Yes, you get a large sum of money. You get a large sum of money all at once, but I'm okay. You know, I'd rather have that for myself. Or I would rather earn that for myself and then. You know, than to just have a baby and give it off to someone else. No, I'm good. I'm okay. So yes, I will be having more children. My family dynamic consists of myself, my husband. I have a 20-year-old. Girls, they're out of the house, and I have a 17-year-old. A 6-year-old. And then it drops down to 10, 7, 6, 3, and now 1 month old. And she's staring at me. And I want another one. The 10-year-old is a boy. The 7-year-old girl. 6-year-old girl. 3-year-old girl. And 1-month-old girl. So I want a boy. I haven't had a boy in 10 years. And my husband hasn't had his own son from his own self, his own loins, since. It's been like 25 years, his oldest son, or his only son. So, I do, I want another boy. And there's nothing wrong with that. I don't understand why, you know, people get so upset when you want to bring children into this world. And, you know, some people go into having children with these preconceived notions like, you know, you're going to ruin their lives. Or I've heard people saying, I don't want to bring people into this horrible world and da 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 da. And well, who said you was gonna make it to see the next world if you believe in that type of thing? So anyway, that's a whole another topic. So yeah, I am definitely going to have more children. And I, like I said, my body, I am able to do it. And you know, when me and my husband was going to my, you know, my OBGYN appointments, the doctors was like, what don't you know? Well, there was a few things that I had not experienced that I had to learn about. But other than that, there's almost just about nothing that I hadn't gone through. And I'm thankful. And it's nothing like being a mother. It's nothing like being able to carry a child for 9 months. And then she's here or he's here and you're rearing her or you're teaching her and you're talking to her and or him and seeing them flourish into this world, whether you like the world or not, it's a blessing. So yes, baby number 10 is coming. I'm sorry, I'm looking at here, I'm looking here. Anyway, I'll get this right eventually, but baby number 10 is definitely coming. My husband was like, well, give her some time to be a baby. I'm like, of course. So probably maybe 2 or 3 more years, this baby will be planned. The next one, just like she was. And, you know, I knew I'm going to be having children well into my 40s. And my doctors, they really didn't bring up my age literally until the last few days of my pregnancy, because they saw my pregnancy was going fine. The only thing that I was lacking was iron, which I already had low blood or low iron before, so it just decreased even more. And I had to have iron infusions in the last month of my pregnancy. But other than that, my pregnancy went fine. I had to be induced, but that's a whole nother story. Well, I had to be induced because they said that I refused to take the diabetes test. You know, when you drink that soda, you fast, you drink the soda, and then they take your blood to see if you're diabetic. Like, my diet does not consist of me being a diabetic, nor am I. 1 second. So, I'm gonna have another baby. And I can't wait. And I'm hoping it's a boy. Or at least I'm hoping I can have some type of control over that. I'm giving myself at least 2 to 3 years. In the meantime, I will be eating, drinking correctly, exercising, and just prepping my body pretty much for it. I think that's the least I could do for myself and for my next baby to come. Because you're not going to be the youngest baby. Sorry. So that's about it. So I just wanted to come in and just do that. Just real quick about myself, my family dynamic, and what I want to do with my own body. All right, you guys.